Moon, the nearest natural satellite of Earth, where we want to build an artificial human colony. And recently, NASA has announced that they have selected Starship to land astronauts on the moon by 2024 for their Artemis program. The current plan calls for astronauts to launch on NASA's Space Launch System, or SLS rocket, to fly to lunar orbit on the space agency's Orion space capsule, and then transfer to a rocket to make the final descent to the surface. And this is where NASA picked SpaceX for a $2.9 billion contract. It's a major vote of confidence in SpaceX from NASA, as no other company received the money. Four astronauts will launch on NASA's Space Launch System aboard the Orion spacecraft. From there, two people will then transfer to SpaceX Lunar Lander. They're going to spend about a week exploring the surface of the moon. Then they're going to get back on board the lander and head back to the Orion. SpaceX is going to have to do an uncrewed flight of this lander before any humans can even come on board. The SpaceX contract is for an uncrewed flight and a single crewed landing. Subsequent landings will be awarded under a follow-up procurement program. NASA said it would begin talking with the industry about the follow-up program next week. There were three major contenders for this project. SpaceX beat out Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin, working with a selection of other aerospace companies like Dynetics, a defense contractor. NASA had previously rewarded all three contenders with a combined $967 million to develop this lunar lander concept, but they liked SpaceX design the most. NASA was expected to pick two companies to receive contracts for this first moon landing since the Apollo program. So by giving this contract to SpaceX alone is a clear slap in the face to Blue Origin in particular, and its team, which included Lockheed Martin and Northrop Grumman. The move to go just with SpaceX signals NASA's massive confidence with the company and can build a version of the Starship that is capable of landing on the moon. Selecting a single contractor also means that NASA can attempt to get back to the moon on the budget Congress has approved. SpaceX's $2.9 billion bid was substantially less expensive than competing proposals, and NASA plans to pay for more than half of the Starship's development cost. But it also means that NASA has no backup option for now. It's pretty unlikely that NASA's gonna need any backup options considering what SpaceX has accomplished in the past few years alone. The SpaceX bid was Starship, the next generation spacecraft the company is building in Boca Chica, Texas. It's expected to be able to carry a crew of astronauts and 100 tons of cargo. Starship is supposed to use its main engines to lower itself on hard surfaces, such as the moon or Mars. Kathy Lauders, the Associate Administrator for NASA's Human Exploration and Operation Mission Directorate, said, "The human landing system is going to allow us to be able to access different parts of the lunar surface. It also allows us to explore new technology and capabilities that will help us when trying to figure out our next round of technologies, which will be able to help us land on Mars and other planets out there." The Artemis mission is going to expand who all has been on the moon, including the first woman and the first person of color. Starship is a heavy lift rocket that is currently being developed by SpaceX. The full rocket consists of two pieces, a 230-foot tall booster called Super Heavy, and a 160-foot tall upper stage called Starship. But SpaceX's lunar lander version might require some changes in order to achieve its goal on the moon. Starting in December 2020, SpaceX has launched four prototypes of the Starship rocket on high-altitude flight test, varying from 10 to 15 kilometers. So far, Starship rockets have flown as high as 41,000 feet. But each of these prototypes are now destroyed. But these prototypes just weren't meant to be used as lunar landers on the moon, so we are expecting many changes in Starship design. NASA also said that its award requires SpaceX to perform an uncrewed demonstration of a lunar landing before shuttling anybody to the moon. The Starship uses Raptor engines for all of its testing and will most likely use it in the future for real-world launches during its missions to places like the moon, Mars, and beyond. These engines are powered by a subcooled liquid methane and subcooled liquid oxygen, which use a more efficient full flow stage combustion cycle. And this is where SpaceX beats all the odds. No methane powered rocket has ever made it to orbit, but Raptor is different. It is designed to make use of every drop of propellant available, making it one of the most efficient rockets ever built. And for many of us, we still don't know a lot of detail about the SpaceX Starship. So let us discuss everything related to Starship. You know what? We might actually need to save this for another episode here on Discover Zen.